Hello, Careblazers. Welcome back. Today we are discussing an exciting new study that could revolutionize how we determine who is at increased risk for developing dementia. This is crucial information for anybody who is concerned about their own cognitive health or a loved one's cognitive health. Before we dive in, let's talk about why it's even important to be able to identify if somebody is at risk. Currently, getting a diagnosis of any type of dementia can be a really long, challenging, drawn-out process. It often involves hours of neuropsychological testing, which can be time-consuming, expensive, emotionally draining for the person having to do the testing and for the family member trying to convince their loved one to go to the appointment. A lot of times, people who are being evaluated don't want to go through with the testing for fear of what those results might show. They might even be in denial or might have anosognosia where they don't think anything is wrong with them, so they don't see the point of having to go through testing. All of these things can delay diagnosis, which can delay treatment. Being able to identify people who are at high risk for dementia is important because it allows for earlier intervention, for being able to potentially do more effective treatment and to slow down some of the symptom development. It also gives family members more time to plan for the future if you knew that you were at particularly high risk. It gives the opportunity to make lifestyle changes that can really make a difference and slow down the progression. It might even qualify somebody for joining a clinical trial and being able to get access to more cutting edge, innovative solutions that are on the horizon. So now, imagine if we had a quicker, simpler way to identify who is at increased risk for developing dementia that does not require hours of testing or invasive procedures. That's where this new study that was published in February 2024 comes in. Researchers from a university in England conducted a large study looking at over 8,600 healthy adults. They were between the ages of 48 years old and 92 years old. These adults took a visual sensitivity test, which basically looked at a person's visual processing speed and reaction time. It was a computerized test where individuals were asked to hit the space bar on a keyboard whenever they saw a triangle starting to form in a field of moving dots on the screen. And what they found is that changes in their visual processing speed could predict dementia up to 12 years before the dementia diagnosis happened. In fact, the lead author of this study said, "We found that a low score on this test, missing many targets, can indicate future dementia risk on average 12 years before the diagnosis." Now, having slowed visual processing speed is not a guarantee that you are going to develop dementia, but this is helpful in a relatively quick way to identify someone who might be a higher risk of developing dementia and could be prioritized into getting some of that full neuropsych testing, and also someone where it would be really important to start implementing healthy lifestyle changes if they haven't already. I can see this being particularly helpful for maybe individuals who are younger age or have not the typical presentation where family members are saying, "I'm noticing changes, something's wrong or something's happening," but they're not quite fitting the typical picture most of us would consider when we think about dementia. Being able to take a look at this test, which could easily be framed as a vision test rather than a dementia test or a cognitive test, so people might be more receptive to taking it, that would be a potential way to identify, okay, something is wrong in their visual sensitivity testing and their visual processing speed. Let's refer them on for more comprehensive assessment. Okay, so here are some signs you can look for in day-to-day life where it might indicate that somebody is having problems with their visual sensitivity and processing speed. Basically, the person can seem like they are reacting more slowly to things that are happening around them, especially if it's a cluttered or a busy environment. They might have trouble finding things in a crowded space or locating something on a busy shelf or in a busy cabinet. They might bump into things more often. They might seem less confident in navigating familiar spaces. They might struggle more with tasks that require quick visual decisions, like with driving, and reading might take longer. They might lose their place more often. So what does this mean for you as a Careblazer? Well, we can't diagnose dementia alone based on this one test, but this could be an indication, especially if you're seeing some of these signs, to talk to a healthcare provider, especially if you notice other changes with memory or other thinking issues. earlier detection of dementia can absolutely lead to better management and care. Again, this is just one piece of a really large puzzle. Definitely more research is needed to identify the link between visual processing speed and dementia, but this is a really exciting start. All right, Careblazers, I hope you found this video helpful. I've linked the full study for you so that you can check it out yourself below in the description. There's also a link for you to check out our Care Collective program where we come together every single week for community support, expert-led Q&A sessions with elder law attorneys, board-certified neuropsychologists, and with people like myself to answer questions and give guidance. All of that information is linked below. I'll be back next week, as always, with a new video. Sending you love. Bye.
Also, Nico gets a belly rub for every person who subscribes from this video. So if you haven't already, click the red subscribe button. It's totally free. And Nico says, thank you very much.